Hey, what's up guys, Jeremy here. In this video, we will use the measure tool to quickly and accurately position objects and robot in your station environment. Let's get started. For this example, let's reopen our folder, measure tool, and let's open cell layout. So you will find here, it's a very simple cell layout where we have a few box cylinders that I created. So the goal will be to position one robot here, one robot here, so a cobot, another cobot, and a bigger industrial robot here, and our RoboDK logo that we imported earlier right here. So generally you could just decide to go in, bring in a UR robot, and try to kind of eyeball the position here. But it will take some time. It won't be super accurate. Even if you figure out like the kind of right position, it won't be super accurate. What you can do instead, and as I already showed you, you can go tools and then measure. You can select the snap on arc center if here extract, automatically extract surface edges is activated. And you can come here and select the center point. It will give you the position here. You press copy. You double click your UR base frame. And then you paste that value here. And the robot will be exactly where the pedestal or the base or bolting base was positioned. So that's a very quick and easy way to position your robot inside your station. Let's do the same, let's say, for this one here. I'm gonna go ahead and pick another robot. So let's go for, I don't know, this one here. It's a bit bigger. Let's go tools and then measure. And then just select this one here. Click copy. I need instead here, instead of using the UR5E base, I need to use the Omron TM14X base. Click paste. And the robot is right on the top here. So this base is a bit bigger, so it doesn't fit really well on my cylinder, but you get the point. Then I can just rotate it as I see fit. So I could do here the same with a bigger robot. So I could go here, open and open a bigger Kuka robot, let's say. So this one here. If I want to position it right in the middle here, I can do here tool, measure, select plane, select this plane here, copy the value of the center point I just measured, and then paste the value here and reposition or reorient the robot as I see fit. So just like that, I was able to position three robots at three very specific positions in a matter of a few seconds. Let's say that I want to bring my object right here. So let's go and get the object we imported earlier. So I can just go and select the logo here we imported. I can drop it onto the robot base here, and I can simply change here the orientation. I don't see it very well here. So just change the orientation like this here. I thought this was a bit bigger. So I will simply apply a scale on it. I think it's gonna be a 3x scale. Could have measured that, honestly. I think it was 4x, to be honest, but yeah. I'm just gonna go for 4x, so control 1 to re-import the object we just imported. I'm gonna go and rotate that 90 degrees like that here, apply scale, and then 4x here. We will talk about scaling in the next video here. I'm gonna bring back the cell, and cool. So let's say that I want to move that piece here right there. One thing I can do, I could use the measurement tool as I showed you, but another method would be the following. So if you go for program T teach target on surface. Remember this one. It will ask you to select a robot in this case because we have many robots. So I'll just go for the UR5. It doesn't matter which one we select, to be honest. And then instead of using add tool or add target, I'm going to go for add frame. And here I'm going to select automatically extract surface corner. So this way, if I go to one of the many corners we have here, it will snap here directly on that corner and will create a frame. So here it's called frame snap. Depending with respect to what I wanted, I could decide here to have it with respect to the UR5 base. So right click, change support, UR5 base. Let's call it with F2 part. And now I can simply bring that part here. And the part is right where I want it. So just like that. Very handy, very quick, very useful. Okay, great. Now there's another thing I want to show you. So if I reopen the station with the organized box station here, I want to talk to you about the absolute feature in the measurement tool. So first of all, we need to know where is our reference frame, our base reference frame of this station, or the origin of this station. So to do that, I can just right click and frame on here the station, make sure that it's visible. So right here. So for now, the station origin and the robot base are coincident at the same spot. So that's cool. If I measure a point here, tool measure, if I measure, let's say a corner, and I have the absolute position here activated, it will give me the position of that corner with respect to the station origin. So with respect to that base or that station origin in this case here, which is the same as the robot origin. So that's great. But if I click absolute, right, if I uncheck absolute here, clear selection, select this one here, it will give me 75, 75. The reason why you have 75, 0, 75, or if I go, let's say, and select the other one here, so this one here, 75, 75, 75, it's because it gives you the relative position of the point you just selected with respect to the object origin you just selected. So here it's not the relative position with respect, let's say, to the parent reference frame. So it could be kind of intuitive. It was the case here. You have one parent, so you're using the block here. I'm gonna go for toggle this one. This is the block here, and it's the first parent is the part here, reference frame, which is this one here. So you might think that by selecting here this corner, it will give you the value of this point with respect to the first parent frame. But in fact, what it does, if I toggle that off and make that invisible and make this invisible too, if I was to bring in the object reference frame, you would see that the object origin is here. So when I select, let's say here, this point here, I'm at 75 millimeters along the x-axis and 75 millimeters along the z-axis and 0 along the y. So that's just a little something you need to know. Another stuff, you can add more features here to select more points, but I don't really see the use case for this. So if you select more points, you can select points, but it will still just give you the distance between the last two points you selected. The only thing is you can go back to those later here and copy the values one by one by just reselecting them here. Again, position is relative. If you go for absolute, it will, by the way, if you can switch from relative to absolute, it's not kind of glued in place or stuck. You can just switch from one to the other. It will simply change the value that it's displaying here when you select here the actual point position with respect to something. So that's pretty much everything for this video. I hope you liked it. In the next one, we will learn how to scale up or down objects so that you can quickly and easily create simulations in RoboDK's environment. Have a great day, guys.